8 years.
And the time keeps ticking. Tick, tick.
You need to ask, are you letting yourself be led by fear or by love?
Fear, 100% fear.
I don't know what the show is.
Why do we play with fire?
What if the workshop happens and nothing changes? What then, Jonathan?
Maybe I'm just wasting my time.
Do you know how many Jonathan Larsons there are? One.
Why should we blaze a trail?
There's not enough time.
I went to 3 friends' funerals last year, and nobody is doing enough. I'm not doing enough.
Try writing about what you know.
What does it take to wake up a generation?
It would be a tragedy to give up what you have.
Take off and fly. Fear or love, baby, don't say the answer.
Actions speak louder than words.
No matter what.
Louder than words. They speak louder. Louder.
Keep going.
It's Anthony Allen Ramos from GLAAD. Nice to see you both. Robin, if I can start with you. You know, thinking about your connection to Rent, obviously, and with In the Heights and Lin-Manuel, how special is it to be a part of telling this story?
I feel mad lucky because Jonathan was like such a special spirit. He's someone that's like a once in a generation. Thank God he happened right before the end of the millennia, so that Lin could be the one for the next millennia. Because I think there was a cutoff as to how many were allowed to be successful at one time,
right.
You know? But it just is like, how lucky that I get to make my Broadway debut in one of Jonathan's shows and then come back and honor him in this way. But also honor like the community that I'm a part of, the Rent family, meaning like the people who've been in the show for all the years that it's run. Like, we run deep. There are email threads, there's a Facebook group, like there is a hardcore love for one another. And there's a love and appreciation and an upliftment for Jonathan himself. A lot of people could have been Michael. A lot of other people could have taken this spot and celebrated him, but the fact that I get to be that person and that I do come from a place of devotion to him, it's a responsibility, but it's a joy and a privilege.
No one else could have played Michael.
No one else, I agree. Alexandra.
Have that, take right. that, I'll occupy that. That space. No one else could have.
That's right. Alexandra, for you, you know, thinking about your own journey to self-discovery, acceptance. How does it feel for you to be a part of telling this story, knowing that it brings so many important conversations and topics for the LGBTQ community to the forefront?
It's so emotional because no one did that honestly the way that Jonathan was able to. He told truth. He showed BIPOC, queer, layered characters and had them at the forefront of his stories. Something that is still a rarity in today's day and age.
Well written and not exploited.
And not exploited and not sensationalized. It's special, it's sacred, it's a lot to live up to, but with his divine guidance, I feel like we were able to execute something that I think he would be really proud of.
I completely agree. And looking at the two of you holding hands, I'm loving this bond with the LGBTQ representation. Robin, what was it like to, you know, share this experience with Alexandra? Because clearly the two of you are very connected to each other.
Yeah, we're really good about sustaining one another and uplifting one another. I think this whole experience right now with the press junket is like, there's such an intensity to us because we're all in a very raw emotional state.
Yeah.
So we've all been surprised by the amount of emotions that we've been experiencing. So I think every now and then we're just like checking in and making sure we're good.
Yeah, we're staying present, you know?
Yeah.
We're gay, we're brown, we're occupying this space. We have a seat at a table that was luckily written for us, but rarely presented to us.
Yeah, I mean, for me as like a Puerto Rican queer man who lost so many elders and didn't, because of that, didn't get to have any role models, not only because they died, but also because nobody wanted to center them. You know, there was a bit of a colonization with the AIDS epidemic, where white gay men were sort of, were very, very centered, and we forgot about the women, mm-hmm. we forgot about the Black and brown folks, we forgot about the lesbian community that looked out for so many of our peeps.
There was a lot of white supremacy that went into silencing and deleting those experiences that we could have learned from, that culture that we could have
It'd be hiding in like just nooks and crannies nooks and just be peeping out.
You gotta find it. You really gotta, yeah. you gotta search for it in a way that is just like, you gotta be a private detective in a lot of moments.
You're just betting mother flowers. You know what I mean? But it's just like so cool now for me to do another period piece. Because Boys in the Band was the same thing. It was like to show a Puerto Rican man, and a gay Puerto Rican man in the 1960s, and to now insert me into the 90s when the crack and AIDS epidemic was happening. Mm-hmm. And then to showcase me as someone who is tethering this gorgeous spirit that just maybe needs some like divine feminine energy and guidance. It's pretty cool. I don't think we've seen that.
No, and I feel like I want to see more from the two of you. I can't wait for that. Whatever the next project is, like you said, gay and brown, we need more of that. So, but congratulations to both of you, and thanks so much for the time, and thanks for all that you do for the community as well.
Thank you.